This is Bazaar Morning Call, broadcasting live from the CNBC TV18 Motilal Oswal Studios in Mumbai.
Good morning. You're with us here on a fresh new edition of Bazaar Morning Call. We are coming to you live from the CNBC TV18 Motilal Oswal Studios. It's a Wednesday morning. Markets are going to be the focus. Yesterday was flat. Can today be different? There's a big data point ahead of us, which is the US CPI, but that's only later tonight. Tomorrow is a stock market holiday as well. So it's going to be an interesting setup as we begin this session. I'm Prashant. Sonia is with me and Reema joins us today on the program. Guys, hi, morning.
Hi, good morning, Prashant.
Good morning, Reema.
And you know, so many cues on Friday as well, right? You have TCS earnings, you have Bharti Hexacom's listing, you have the India CPI data
and
as well.
And the IIP data.
So there's so much to look forward to.
But all this is going to come post-market as, except the Bharti Hexacom listing.
Yes. So lots of course, things to watch today.
Oh, absolutely. And, the point is, because tomorrow is a holiday, it also kind of, you've got that in the mix as well. So if you're trading, that becomes important because you'll be kind of sort of reacting to some of this stuff. Now, just to kick off things, right, we'll begin where we left off yesterday, which is, of course, the flat close. Absolutely flat yesterday. Large caps for the second day running, like Tuesday, that is yesterday, outperforming small and mid caps. Although small caps did not do too badly. Bank Nifty, private banks participated at the margin. But all in all, it didn't really go anywhere, directionally speaking, although we had a big pop, right? So from the highs, the market did come off quite a bit, but as expected. Now, overnight, US equities are higher. S&P is up a little bit. The Nasdaq is up about 1/3%. Yields have dropped a big time. There is no real impulse or no real big data point which would have perhaps cost it, but we're back at about 4.35 after, getting to about 4.45. So the 10-year dropped about 7 basis points. Dollar index absolutely flat, 104.1. But it's now closer to 104 than it's been to 105 recently. Oil prices are also down about 1%. And the high was 91. From 91, we're at about 89.48. This is all incremental. But then, when you're tracking markets day on day, what matters is the marginal movement or the incremental move. Now, global markets, as I said, are awaiting the US CPI number. And this is important. In the last 6 months, the CPI has gotten out a strong market reaction on the way up, on the way down. And this is important because we've had strong data, which is going in one direction. And you've got Fed speak, especially from Fed Chair Powell, which is going in another direction. Powell, of course, has been saying that, he'd like to cut. Data, of course, is stronger. Take labor market data, the monthly jobs data. We've had 3 months of blowout labor market data, which has come through. The last one, of course, we got last week. Now, a soft CPI print could quickly reprice a June cut. The probability of June cut perhaps will go up sharply higher if the print is softer. The core number is expected about, the consensus is at about 0.28%. Now, market is pricing in 64 basis points of cuts by the end of this year, starting with the first cut in September. And this is, by the way, this market pricing is the most hawkish that we've had since October of 2023. So, given all of this, I think it becomes important to track which way the number comes through. Now, just to circle back and tie in the levels on the market, for the Nifty, keep supports very, very close by supports at about 22,580. So, roughly about 22,600, which is about 40, 60 points away from where we are. That's the trailing reversal, kind of a near-term stop. And on the way up, we put this level out yesterday as well. I think upside targets are pending. Weekly upper Bollinger Band stands at, you're basically now using extensions because the markets are at all-time high. That number stands at 22,955 for the Nifty. The Nifty Bank can look to target 49,257, again, based on the weekly bands. So that's the upside level, and the support for the Nifty Bank can be kept at 48,200. These are hourly averages, the 40 hourly, which we are looking at as far as the Nifty Bank is concerned. So, the setup is quite decent. The GIF Nifty will come up on your screen. The CPI number will be important, but the complication in that sense is that we will not be there to react to it tomorrow morning, whatever comes our way. And how the U.S. markets react, that's only going to be day after, which is on a Friday morning. It's like a opening that, yesterday, same time, GIF Nifty was indicating a 90-point higher start, and I was saying, that seemed excessive. We got a 90-point start, and then we got a completely flat close. So we'll see. Cues, of course, from the global arena, a bit more positive today as compared to yesterday. But it's a big data point. So, you know, if you're trading day on day, I mean, better to be a little cautious at the margin. You can always get back in once you have certainty which way the number is coming. Sonia.
Oh, absolutely. And I think, you know, the implied opening is suggesting a very strong opening for our own markets, yeah. Right? Almost 90 points higher. And if you look at the data points, it indicates that the uptrend is pretty much intact for our own markets. Even the global markets, they were very quiet. The Dow and the S&P closed flat, but still very stable at all-time highs. If you look at our own markets, the Nifty has been really strong at the 22,600 mark. And, you know, the question I'm asking is this a bit of a breather before the uptrend resumes in the market? Because look at the data points, right? There was large buying from domestic institutions yesterday. DIA has bought almost 2,300 crores in the cash markets. We've also had, you know, a situation where gold is hitting record highs, and we've talked ad nauseum about that, about how there is so much buying from central banks across the world, especially China buying so much gold. So is there a tectonic shift of the, you know, powers at play away from the West and into the East because of large buying that China is seeing in gold and hedging themselves against the US dollar? So that is something that the street is looking at as well. There are a lot of things to watch on Friday. Tomorrow, of course, is a market holiday, but there's TCS earnings post-market hours, there's the Bharti Hexacom listing, there's the CPI inflation data, and that is important to judge what the next step of the RBI will be, whether there are any rate cuts that could come through earlier than expected. So a lot of cues to watch out for this week. But I reckon today would be a good day for the markets overall, and especially for some of these pockets like banks, etc., that have been assuming leadership in the past few days. For now, the Asian markets are also doing quite well, actually. The Hong Kong market is up almost 1.5%. So it looks like it's going to be a pretty good start.
Absolutely. Hang Seng's up 1.2%. But you've got a little bit of softness in the Japanese market. That's down 0.3%. And markets in Singapore and South Korea are shut today on account of Eid. So they're celebrating the Eid holiday today while we have a holiday tomorrow. But today is also the Nifty Bank weekly expiry. So keep your eye on that. And tomorrow's weekly expiry for the Nifty 50 has been preponed. So today you've got the Nifty Bank weekly expiry and the Nifty 50 weekly expiry taking place today. So just keep that on your mind.
Well, absolutely. And Rima, thanks very much for that. Well, we'll get to more in just a bit, but I'll tell you what's lined up here, like in the next 30 minutes or so. So Cameron Brandt of EPFR Global will join in to discuss flows. That's coming up right after now. Our research team gets you the top 10 stocks to watch out for with our research team that's also lined up. And we have our market guest, Devin Choksi of DR Choksi FinServ, who will be with us with specific names in news and, of course, what he'd like to like you to bet on.
All right, let's kickstart the show with a view coming in from Ridham Desai of Morgan Stanley, who says that the margin expansion will likely continue to drive earnings growth. He says the top line growth may remain tepid. He adds India continues to be in the midst of an earnings upcycle, and there are buyers of financials, consumer discretionary, industrials and technology, while avoiding external facing sectors.
Some money market views as well. This is Kunal Sudhani of Shinhan Bank, who says US Fed officials are playing good cop, bad cop, leaving market participants to decide for themselves. He says the outcome of the inflation figures will set the tone for the market bets on the Fed, while today's FOMC minutes are important to watch as well. He says the dollar index finds resistance at 104.85. For the rupee here, the dollar rupee, Kunal says 83.1 to the dollar acts as a support, while 83.35 is the resistance.
And on the bonds, you have Neeraj Gambhir of Axis Bank, who says during the week, bonds remain under pressure on account of a rise in US Treasury as well as crude oil. He also says India MPC maintained the status quo and reiterated that inflation needs to moderate on a durable basis, diminishing any rate cut expectations. He adds that Friday's stronger than expected US non-farm payroll data supported the Fed's patient approach about rate cuts. Neeraj says the new 10-year bond came in at 7.1% at Friday's auction, and he expects the 10-year benchmark bond yield to trade in a range of 7.1 to 7.2% and take cues from the CPI data this week.
We have also a lot of stock-specific action that we'll be tracking, and we'll get to it in just a bit in our special top 10 segment. We're looking at Shyam Metalics, Lupin, Paisalo Digital and Godavari Power. These are stocks which are likely to open in the green, while Protean, eGov, Paytm, Motilal Oswal Financial Services, Latent View, ONGC Oil India are the stocks on our radar that are likely to open in the red.